CDR.
Hey yo, what's good, man? It's your boy Willy Northpole, Disturbing the Peace. I'm here live and direct. I'm in NYC right now, Arizona. Definitely stand up, and I want to give it up to my niggas, my homeboys, y'all family, cause we family. Crack distributors, holla at your boy. Yeah.
Gangster with it, black rag, gangster fitted, tattoo from the land of where the man say the gangsters did it. They say me, I kinda lie, say I ain't did it, cause I'm a G and I go hard to the paint with it.
It's your boy Sean, man. Crack Distributors Radio. We in the building right now with your dude, Willy Northpole.
What's good with you, homie?
What it is, man? How you feeling right now?
I'm feeling good, man. I'm in New York. This fucking snow is kicking my ass right now, man.
Man, you ain't telling nothing.
West Arizona, man. I ain't used to this shit, man. I walked outside, man. That snow was, man, it's crazy.
The process of you joining the ranks of DTP. We know you was with G-Unit for a second. You was riding with them. And now you're with Disturbing the Peace, man. Let me know how it happened.
What I want niggas to understand, man, I was never signed to G-Unit. I'm not trying to, you know, get no fame off of G-Unit, saying I was a part of them or anything like that. What it was, one of my niggas had a deal, you know what I'm saying? His situation was bringing people to the table, you know what I'm saying? He scooped me up, 50 Cent, we stayed at 50's house, and we was recording in his house. Now, was I going to be signed to G-Unit? I don't know. You know what I'm saying? It was just the process. The shit wasn't going the way that I thought it was going to go, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, whatever happened here and there, so I just did back to Phoenix. When I went back to Phoenix, I had to just basically get my own deal, you know what I'm saying? Good manager was on it. She knew a couple of people, you know what I'm saying? She, shout out to Cordiga. Cordiga was working inside of DTP, but I had CTE looking at a nigga. I had, I think Show Enough at the time was, you know what I'm saying? It was a couple of labels looking at me, but you know, Luda bit it, and they flew me out to California with Shaka. I met Shaka, met Chris for the first time. We was in Shaka's suite, you know what I'm saying? They had the presidential and shit, you know what I'm saying?
For you for a second.
Yeah, you know, it was nice in there, man. So niggas, they was bumping the demo, and nigga went through like two or three songs and said he wanted to sign me, man, you know?
That's real right there, man.
You know, my buzz was already out there in Arizona, so, you know, trying on the West Coast, trying to get it out there too. And Shaka just, he checked my background. He went through the whole process of, you know, checking for us artists to make sure I wasn't on the funny shit.
Yeah.
Or whatever, had a jacket or whatever. he did use his sources, and whoever he knew in Arizona vouch. You know what I'm saying? And from there, man, they brought the paperwork, you know. I signed it in the hood. They brought the papers to me. I signed it around my niggas and shit. You know, you can watch it on YouTube, actually.
Yeah, no
the
doubt.
The whole signing, you know what I'm saying?
I actually saw that, too, man.
You saw that?
Yeah, I saw it,
I think
too.
He had the stacks with the pistols and the niggas behind. I hit Tiffany in the head with the bottle.
With the contract.
Exactly. With the contract. Right. It's crazy.
Coming into the game right now pretty heavy, man. You laying the game down lyrically. Do you feel like it's important for new artists to be on top of their game lyrically when they come out?
Right now, man. The way the game look right now, man, I don't know what you gotta do, bro, for real. As far as for me,
yeah,
my fan base, I'm cut from a different cloth, man. I'm from the era when you know, with the Tupac and the Biggies and the Bone Thugs and the Harmonies and the Snoops, the Death Rolls, when niggas was making records.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And your whole album was smashing, besides a single and a bunch of bullshit.
No doubt.
You know what I'm saying? I wasn't even concerned about a single. My thing was putting together a well album. From the skits to from the intro, I want the intro to blaze all the way to the end. So, I just happened to have a single. You know what I'm saying? And I was doing it to make a hit, but at the same time, my nigga, I was really doing it to make a great album. So, as far as hip-hop, I don't know what you have to do, to be honest, man, because there's a lot of good MCs out there that ain't getting their props.
Yeah.
And it's kind of scary, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not knocking nobody that's getting money, but I'm just saying, as far as what I represent and how what I perceive as real music, I don't think we're getting the respect that we deserve, man. So, you know, sometimes you got to dumb shit down to get a motherfucker's attention. And then at the same time, man, it's a new generation, you know what I'm saying? You can't really knock this generation for liking what they like. Dance, they want to, you know, club, whatever, which is cool, you know, and I got shit for that ass, don't get me wrong, I'm very, you know, multi-talented, but at the same time, I don't know what you need right now, bro. I can't even answer that question for you,
because
it's damn near sick right now what it is, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's sad, right?
The game is falling, man. You gotta prove yourself as a new artist, man.
It's sad, man, and I wish it could change, but hey, but
is.
I think, you know, with the Kanye's, the T.I.'s, you know, myself, the Wang's, the Jay-Z's, who else, man? Just, the Jeezy's. I think with niggas like that, if they just stay consistent, we can always have that foundation.
Of course, of course.
Because if you think about it, it's only a handful of niggas that's still doing it the right way.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I can count my 5 or 6 right now.
Exactly. You know, okay. it's maybe on one hand that's doing it the right way. You know what I'm saying? Even Luda, you know what I'm saying? Just like whatever, who's ever making good music, they just have to stick around. It's sad because a lot of these niggas been doing it so long, it's almost time to hang it up. So that's sad.
That's sad.
I'm gonna be sad when them niggas leave the gang, bro. I want niggas to rap till they 50 the way shit is going right now.
Well, yeah. Right. And it's the same artists who've been so consistent, so it's scary.
Yeah, you know, man, it's scary because think about it. They time, like, niggas' times is almost, niggas is billionaires right now. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They own a whole nother scale of money.
Yeah.
Whole nother tax bracket. So it's gonna be hard for them to just keep up with this bullshit that everybody, I'm not gonna say bullshit, but this shit that everybody wanna hear right now. You know what I'm saying? It's hard. It's hard to do that when you got a love for music. When you love the music, it's different.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You love the music, you're going to make real music. It's hard to just, you know, say, fuck it. Let's make a song called Jump on the Table. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Motherfuckers start jumping on tables and clubs and shit. And that's what sells right now.
Crazy, man. You just talked about Phoenix, man. How does it feel being, like, the premier artist right now coming out of Arizona, man?
I feel good, man. You know, a couple people came out of Arizona, but, you know, as far as being born and raised, I was the only one that was born and raised.
Oh, okay.
I'm from the streets of Arizona, like, born and motherfucking raised.
That's real.
My moms, my pops, grandmas, everybody, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And when people think of Arizona, they don't see it as that hood type shit, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not here to glorify the hood or anything like that, but it's real anywhere you go. And that's what I want niggas to understand. Anywhere you go, it's going to be, it's real niggas out there. You can go to motherfucking Timbuktu and see some real niggas out there. You know what I'm saying? So where I'm from just happens to be the bad part. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I represent, cause that's where I'm from. I'm from South Phoenix, Broadway, 24th Street. You know what I'm saying? And we from the West, man. And, you know, I think, you know, me being through the shit I've been through in my life, you know, I've been through over 20 funerals in my life, just my niggas alone, my personal homies. You know what I'm saying? So it's real out there, man. I just want to show that, not so much the violent part, but just show what it is, you know, what it's worth, yeah.
Right now we talked about we've seen a connect, you mentioned the connect a few times, man. It's your first major label debut, man. So tell me who was involved in the creation of the whole joint, man, as far as production wise.
Production, man, I worked with everybody I wanted to work with.
Yeah.
So that was a good thing about the connect. You know, I feel like it's a well put together album, you know what I'm saying? I like to play some records for y'all, you know, later on when we're done.
Definitely.
But it's definitely, you know, something that I've been working on since I was a kid. We on the production, we got fucking Jelly Roll, we got Bangladesh, you know what I'm saying? We got Reefa, we got Black Elvis, we got, you know, we got the little homie Wonka who produced Body Marked Up.
Oh, wow.
Kid was 14 years old when he made that beat, you know
that's
what I'm saying?
Crazy.
And that's the song that got me signed, actually. Let me see, who else? Let me make sure I got everybody, man. Let me see, Wonka. We got El Timo, you know what I'm saying? We got, forgive me if I missed you, man, but you know, just going through the whole list, I worked with a lot of niggas, man.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It was, and they gave me the best of the best. And I actually got a chance to go in and work with all these cats instead of just them sending me beats.
Yeah.
We actually went together and put some shit together, you know what I'm saying?
That's what it did. What do you want your legacy to be after you leave the game, man?
Strong.
Yeah.
I want it to be more than just a nigga with a white t-shirt with jewelry on or some Versace glasses.
That's
you know what
it
saying?
Is, yeah.
I want it more than that, man. I don't want to just be, I just don't want to come and go, man. I want to be known. And not even just, you know, I hate when niggas say I'm not a rapper, but I really want to be that motherfucking nigga. You know what I'm saying? I want to be that entertainer to the point to where niggas just respect me, to where you got all these other groups, you know, people outside of hip hop wanting to work with me.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I just don't want to be classified as a 16 spitter, lyricist. You know, it's a lot more than Willie, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I want to be known for making great music. You know what I'm saying? Just like all the greats is leaving. You know what I'm saying? If Jay was to leave right now completely, he'd be known as one of the greatest. Even if, you know, Jeezy's and niggas like that would walk out right now. You know, them niggas actually make good music. You know, so that's why I want to be. You know, I want to be on that level, Kanye level. Or, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no
Snoop
doubt.
Level, yeah. Definitely.
That's
icon.
That's what it is.
Body marked up like the subway and hard. Body marked up like the subway and hard. Body marked up like the subway and hard. Body marked up, body.